Twix man in the mix with Twix. New York City time, you rocking with the best. I'm out here swagger splashing with no hands. You looking at the UFO in person. Everybody wanna know karate, but nobody wanna wax on, wax off. And I'm fresher than the Listerine strip. What's up? Brooklyn is always in the house. We doing it like we doing it for TV. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. To no surprise, I'm always amongst the elite talent. I'm actually in East New York right now, you know what I'm saying? And not for nothing, y'all probably already know what it's hitting for. I'm with Project Heat right now. You know what I'm saying? And I'm going to allow everyone to introduce themselves if you don't already know what it's hitting for. So I'm going to start off with the bro right here.
Yo, y'all know who I am, man. You know, yeah. Pop, man. No doubt. I play character Pop on Project Heat. I'm the creator. I'm the writer. I got co-writers. My partner's Sha, KD, you know what I'm saying? They helped me with the writing and all that. They can't be here, but shout out to them. You know, and my character, basically, it's like I got a black cloud following over me. Everything is happening to me, and it's like first my girl got killed, you know, then my sister getting shot, and then my brother getting killed in jail, and it's like, yo, now what I'm gonna do? I can't take but so much, so you're gonna see me put that work in that funeral home, because I'm after them niggas that, you know what I'm saying, that shot my sister. And season 3 is going to be crazy, you know what I'm saying? You're going to see me turned up all the way. So be tuned.
And season 3, y'all shooting in January?
We ain't got no specific date because we dropping Project Heat Atlanta on Thanksgiving Day. So right after that, then you're going to season 3. Okay. Project Heat, boy.
No doubt. I ain't going to front the way you just sold that. Like, I thought that was your real life. Like, I was like, oh, man, it's crazy.
No. Don't get it twisted. A lot of shit that's in there, it's real shit that happened to me and, you know, people that lived in these projects, in pink houses. Like, when my sister got shot, I actually got shot in real life in my neck. But I ain't want to do the reenactment of that, so I let my sister do it, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, one of my nephews got locked up for a body that he ain't commit. And you see in Project Heat, I think episode 4 or 5, when one of the dudes stabbed him up and blamed it on, you know, one of my brothers. So that's how my brother got locked up, but it was actually one of my nephews.
So you want to know something? Let me take that back, because, like, I don't want to make a joke out of nothing at the end of the day. Like, no, I'm going to keep it real because, you know, I was going to get into that later during the interview, like, you know, what was real and, you know, what was fiction. I was just going to say, I was going to ask what was it based on. So not for nothing, you know, I definitely take that back. A quick plug for the viewers that's just getting in tune with me. When I start stuttering, it don't mean I'm nervous or scared. It just mean my brain be clicking so fast I can't get the words out fast enough. So, yo, Pop, good looking with that, brother. And, yo, listen, tell them who you are. Tell them your participation. What Project Heat, my guy?
Yeah, I'm Henny. I play Henny. My name's Shamal. I play Henny. I play a character that's got a sickness. I'm dealing with a sickness with diabetes. But at the same time, I'm still working out here. Putting in working for my team. You already know. Project Heat, caveman side.
No doubt, caveman side. Hey, yo, tell them who you are, my G, if they don't already know.
My name is Kareem. I play Big Reem on Caveman Side / Hollywood. You know, but I don't rock with the Hollywood, but, you know. But, you know, a lot of things going on, man, in Project Heat, man. It's very tuned in. You got to tune in. You're going to enjoy it. As for me, I just play that dude. I'm all over the place. I'm real grimy, sneaky. You know, never know what's gonna come. But, oh, you know, I'm just here to bring that magic and to give you that raw talent, baby, you're looking for, you heard?
No doubt.
You know what I mean?
No doubt. Hey, well said, my brother. Hey, yo, tell them who you are. Tell them your participation, my brother.
Well, you already know what it is. It's your boy Hollywood Trigg from Hollywood side. You know what I'm talking about? The opposing side. But other than that, yo, I play a loyal soldier for my man Jay, who's the boss of Hollywood side. I go in for the squad, no matter what it is, whatever I have to do, I stand strong in what I have to do to represent what we represent, and we represent all the time, Hollywood. You know what it is.
No good. Hey, yo, tell them who you are and your participation with Project Heat, my guy.
First, bro, my name is Majestic. I play young character Ike in the show. I'm a young boy, pack boy, keep everybody out of trouble. Right now, I'm not really digging this Hollywood dude standing next to me, but season 3, you know, I'm the youngest out of the whole caveman gang. So season 3, we see them rebels take off. You gonna see me come out of that little shell because nobody pay attention to me, and that's what's good. You know what I'm saying? Watch what happens.
No doubt, no doubt. Hey, yo, shout out. Hey, yo, shout out to all of the actors and actresses that, you know, wasn't able to show up today. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to everybody, the whole Project Heat staff, from, you know what I'm saying, the writers, the actress. I mean, even down to the water boy. Like, everybody plays a large contribution to the set, because that's just how it is. Hey, come closer, right? Because I see you frowning up over there. Hey, tell them who you are.
I'm Shane B, baby.
Shane B, baby. You always saying Shane B, baby. Shane B, baby, from where?
I'm from Brooklyn, everywhere, but I'm also from the Mixie Room, so shout out to them.
Shout out to the Mixie Room.
Yeah, shout out to the Mixie Room, and I'm down with In the Mix with Twix.
And that's a Snapple fact. All right, so, you know, we definitely gonna get into what we got going on right now, which is Project Heat. You know, first and foremost, I want to say, you know, thank you to everybody who showed up, you know what I'm saying, and gave me the opportunity, you know what I mean, to interview such a, you know, a prominent cast. Like, not for nothing, y'all already know this is, like, one of the number one web series in the entire world right now, you know what I'm saying? So shout out to that. Shout out to all of y'all. Like, y'all dudes is all the way up right now. So, yeah, say it.
I want to definitely... You know, let everybody know we're doing the first annual Urban Web Series Awards show going down January 20th at NYU, the Canton Theater. So be tuned. We're going to post up. You're going to post up stuff on Facebook and Instagram, you know, to give you the address, the time, you know what I'm saying? But we definitely going to, you know, ball out with that one.
Are you guys selling tickets, or is it just is this walking in?
Nah, we selling tickets. You can't just walk in. You got to be dressed up, too. So,
no,
you know what I'm saying? It's going to be a nice event.
Okay. Hey, not for nothing. Is the Twix man invited, brother?
You here, right?
That's a big fact. Yo, thank you. Thank you so much. Hey, listen, not for nothing, man. I'm going to need one of them good hats right there. And not for nothing, man. If I'm not asking for too much, I'd like to play a little role or something. Let me just say a little one to it. And a little sick. Listen, can I live a little bit?
You want your cameo on, huh?
I want my cameo. That's it.
We got room for a lot of people, you know what I'm saying? So we definitely could get you in a role or two, you know what I'm saying? So you definitely got it, Twix.
I appreciate it.
Twix.
Oh, that's a big fact. Hey, yo, you know, for the viewers that don't know, could you let them know where Project Heat derived from and let them know, you know, just the origins of it, if you don't mind?
Oh, it started from, you know, Pink Houses, where we at right now. Mm-hmm. So this is the infamous Pink Houses. Everybody, you know, you look us up, it's a red flag. You know what I'm saying? And people scared to come in. But, you know, when you live this, you're immune to it, you know? And it's like now, you know, the time had changed, but it still goes down, you know? So I'm bringing light to a lot of things that happen to me and other people, you know? So then, and it's not only happening in Pink Houses. It happens around the world. So that's why we're going worldwide with it, because every project have a story to tell. So we're going to be in Atlanta, then we're going to hit up Houston, and then we're going to hit up LA.
I ain't going to front, not for nothing. You know, with your future endeavors, talking about, you know, taking it to other regions, you kind of, you know, not kind of, but you are definitely ahead of the curve, because, you know, a lot of the web series, I mean, I know we know the money and violence, you know what I'm saying? Like there's a couple more out here, but a lot of them, they just keep it very regional, you know, very in a neighborhood, and they don't kind of, like, get outside of that. So y'all definitely ahead of the curve, taking it to Atlanta and everywhere else. So let me ask you a question. When you, like, because the web series is based on two sides of the field, I'm very unfamiliar with this territory right here, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't really get too much experience over here. Is the caveman in the Hollywood, like, is that real drama?
Oh yeah, that happened when I first moved out here in the 80s. You know, I came in here, you know, I was a young buck, but the dudes in Hollywood, on Hollywood side, didn't like me because I was just a fresh, you know, fresh face, and I had to, you know, let niggas know I'm not the one to be fucked with. So that's how the drama became with me, my side, and the Hollywood side. And then, you know, it's a lot of other, you know, sides that's going to war right now, you know, but I ain't going to put that out there right now.
Okay, so basically you saying that, you know, even in current times, it's still a little staticky between, you know, between different buildings and stuff like that?
Yeah, for sure, because it's never going to die out. Drama never going to die out, because it's going to be somebody, a knucklehead, that want to, you know, try to be a big shot and start the drama back up.
You know, Guapi a little 7:30. You know he not letting that go, so we gonna have to go to war.
We all 7:30. It is what it is. But right now, bro, we got war. We at war. I'm not playing. Everybody that come over, I'm laying them down. Tell everybody to tool up. You already know what time is it. We ain't talking to nobody. I don't care what he is.
Let them know, you know, where you come from.
Well, you know, I come from East New York, born and raised, you know. The issues that go on inside the projects, everybody don't talk about, you know, because everybody have a story. Everybody go through different stages in their lifetime. You know what I mean? Nobody talk about what goes on inside of here, because we people too. You know what I mean? Everybody have kids, go through different things, triumphs, tribulations, you know what I'm saying? Inside the community, in the projects. So on the outside, look, you they look at it as different, like, oh, they from the projects. But everybody come from the projects, don't act projectist all the time. You know what I mean? Because there's a lot of people that's intelligent.
Yeah, and get up and go to work every morning, you know what I'm saying? Like, and hold good positions, you know what I'm saying? Like, you can never judge a book by its cover. Let me get something from you. Where you from?
I'm from Pink House, the caveman side, born and raised over here, man.
So just touch on some of the, you know, issues and topics that's, you know, relative to what goes on in the web series.
It's a lot of things in the web series that's going on nowadays today. Like, you see, it's still drugs getting sold in projects, shootings and all that. But like Pop said, when you lived around it so much, you get used to it. So to me, it's nothing. I watch it every day. I seen stuff happen growing up. I done seen bodies drop, all that. So it's nothing new to me. So I know how it is out here. I just know how to stand on my own 2 feet and handle my business.
No doubt. Well said.
These two, him and Majestic, is my nephews.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Yo, Majestic, come closer. Would you give, you know, the viewers some, you know, some insight on, you know, where you from and, you know, just your intake on what's going on around here?
Listen, I'm from the cave. I was raised over here, grew up. All I know is it's real. It was real back then, it's still real now. Like, it's like we, like, this is like, it's real. It's not just acting. It's based on true stories, true events. It's still going on to this day. Everybody want to know why it happens in the projects. We basically showing what's up. It's not just happening just because we're in the projects and it's the projects. It's reasons why people do everything. So, insight, that's all it is, man.
Mm-hmm. Hey, yo, Pop, how did you go about, you know, picking out your cast? Because, you know, you definitely have a sturdy group of folks around you. Like, how did you go about that? I know you didn't have a casting call. Like, how'd you go about that?
Nah. Everybody that's on this cast is related or friends of mine that I know personally, you know. And, you know, I definitely commend them because they dedicated. They've been there from day one. You know what I'm saying? And without them, it wouldn't have really been no Project Heat. You get what I'm saying? I wrote the script in a movie format. So when I presented to my two partners, because everything, I work with my two partners. I presented to them, they was like, yo, it's kind of too straightforward. You know, and we got to put some twists and turns. So KD came up with an idea like, yo, we should add a developer. Somebody that's trying to take down projects and make it into a good community. And that was a great idea. So, you know, with my writing and his little twist to it, him and Shy put a lot of twists and turns into it. And I commend them, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, KD, he's the one that actually films all the episodes. And Shy, she's the editor. So, you know, when I wrote it out, you know, I submitted to a lot of the characters. You know, we first it was like with him, you know, with him, Trigger, and Hollywood J, Core, Mona's Mom Barker, you know what I'm saying? And Dio, you know, that's a situation we ain't gonna talk about, but those are the main, like, from day one, we was right, like, this hallway and that hallway over there, we was in the snow, cold. It was right here, getting it. Like, yo, we gonna do it, and everybody stayed dedicated. Now look where we at now.
No doubt. Hey, yo, when did you shoot your first episode?
Last year, around February.
Last year, February, And if you look at this time, it's like, I'm just trying to tell you, like, you know, like, you really could do what you want to do, long as you do it. Like, you know my slogan, everybody really want to know karate, but nobody want to wax on, wax off. You know what I'm saying? Like, you really have to wax on, wax off if you want to do, if you want to get to a certain level. Shane B., do you have any questions that you want to ask while we're in the mix?
I pretty much interview them, like, I could take it in.
Of course. Why not?
I pretty much interview them, like, more than once, right, yeah. At this point, Pop. But I do want to touch on some things that you guys said. As far as you being numb to situations that go on here, right, it really shouldn't be that way. But that's not your fault. Like you said, not everybody from the projects is the projects. It's just like any building, like a church or a corporate building. It's a building. But we have to understand as black people that it's designed that way. It's like a rat race. So you put like 1,000 people in here and maybe about 50 people in a brownstone, and now we think we're different. So we take down that common denominator, we'll understand we're on the same level and we looked at the same way, right? Then we can get past that. Then we can actually fix that. Because even though it was crazy back then, it should not be crazy now. So what I like about your web series is that I feel like y'all bring light to a situation. I just really hope that our youth is getting that message, that it's not a game. Like, you understand, shit happened. We should not, our parents should not outlive us. That's one, unless we die of a natural cause. Our men should not be dying in the street. We need y'all. I don't think that y'all clearly understand that when y'all going out to do stuff. And some women don't either when we're encouraging y'all to do those things. Instead of just stepping up saying, well, I don't want you out there. I want you doing this, follow your dream as you are. So I'm going to get a second job. I'm going to get a third job. I'm not going to stress you about the kids. So it's all about community and us supporting each other. So I'm happy to be here with you guys for a third time, and I'm very proud of you.
First time. Hey, listen, I ain't gonna front. You should move to the projects. You know what I'm saying? So you, she should move to the projects. No, you should move back. You come to the pink houses. You know what I'm saying? And you should do some community service because you always talking very positive. You know what I'm saying? And not for nothing. It's always a good word to hear. You know, I understand that because this is being recorded, so people are definitely gonna hear it. So let me ask you a question. You know, money and violence. You know, one of the another noteworthy web series. Have you spoke to Rafe or any of them guys over there?
Oh yeah, of course. We did a I was on a panel with Rafe for the Hip Hop Film Festival. We was talking to the up and coming you know, web series that want, you know, advice, because, you know, we on top, and we gave him good advice. And you know, Rafe is a good dude. Like, that wasn't my only time meeting him. Before even Money Violence popped off. Popped off, me and him had a long conversation, like an hour or two, because he was getting, you know, his name was getting out there. And, you know, I spoke to him, we spoke, and then I ran into him and Miz downtown, and he was like, yo, what's up? So, you know, that's when we first started Project Heat. So when you know.
Started, you know what I'm saying? Like, people are very prone to talk to you when you first start something, but when you start becoming competition, it's a little different, right? They like, hold on, like, we don't need to give you no more sauce though, right?
Nah, but you know, they good. Like, we was just with them last night, you know, at an event. You know, he seen me like, oh, what's up? I didn't even know that was you. So we parley for a little minute, then, you know, we went our ways. But them dudes is good, man. You know what I'm saying? And they opened the door, and they definitely made a way for, you know, these web series that's out now.
No doubt. So, you know, like you said, you've only been shooting this web series for a year, correct?
Yeah, in a couple months.
Year and a couple months. I ain't gonna hold you. I can't even stress the fact that, you know, a year and a couple months translate to something. So it's this nationwide, bro.
See, we since then we got a lot of you know, people that been hitting us up. Like, we've been on Channel 5 News twice. We've been on.
That's real.
Yo, and they've been hitting us up because of, you know,
in the this, comment section and all that, right?
Yeah, like, they was hitting us up hard. And, you know, we've been on Fox 5 twice. We've been on 1010 Wins. We've been on Channel 11, Channel 12, Al Jazeera, America Tonight. We just did Daily Vice. I was in Vice Magazine. We did a lot of, like, and they noticed us from, you know, the web series, Project Heat. And when you watch the first episode, is the actually reenactment of Akai Gurley. And that's what really got us, you know. I'm going to give homage to Vice Magazine, because when they put us in that magazine, we took off, like, the next day, like 30,000 views.
Damn.
The next day, I mean.
Instant. It's the power. Not for nothing. A lot of publications and a lot of artists and, you know, just people have that power. Like, you know, like I always say this, like, people are really just one hit away. Like, if Jay-Z said my name tonight, tomorrow, everything is on the house. You understand what I'm saying? Like, it's that real. Like, and it's so sad that a lot of people don't show that love. Like, you know how, you know, clout goes a long way. If I'm Jay-Z and I say your name one time, be on the lookout for my bro right here, it's lit for you. You know, so it's just that, you know, like you said, it is a rat race sometimes because, like, sometimes we don't like to see each other, you know, go too far. But we definitely going to go far, you know what I'm saying? But, yo, what you trying to accomplish with the web series? Like, where you trying to take it? Because right now, you know, the web series is so popular that, you know, people are getting deals off it now. You know what I'm saying? Like where you trying to take it?
Yeah, we got a couple situations on the table, too, now. Like, I got three, actually, deals on the table to be in negotiation with. And I want to take it worldwide. I mean, it is worldwide, but I'm talking about on the big screen. Yeah. So people, like, a lot of people, they compare us to, like, the new modern day of The Wire.
That's a fact.
You know,
that's
and
a fact,
that's so, a fact. But, you know, we in a different lane. I mean, it's good to compare us to them, you know, because they was a very successful series. So it's good to compare us with them, but we want to take it elsewhere, like, different regions. Mm-hmm. So, you know, and with that being said, like, that's where I want to definitely take it. I want to take it to the big screen.
How are you dealing with, you know, the notoriety? Like how you dealing with everybody, you know, knowing who you are? Like, are you taking full advantage of it? Or you being humble?
I'm very humble because, you know, it's good that, you know, I created a project that's being well known. And, you know, with the fans seeing me on the street, stopping me, taking pictures. It's really, it feels good, man. Like, they be like, oh, that's Pop. Yo, Pop, yo, you don't mind if I take it? I love the kids. That's number one. And that's what I'm aiming to for them to, you know, let me rephrase that. Take lessons from Project Heat because this is what I don't want y'all to do. So when you see it, don't glorify it. Think about what you want to do in life because that's where I want y'all to go. I want y'all to achieve what y'all want out of life. Point blank. You understand what I'm saying? But back to the fans, like, the fans, they treat me good, man. Like, I could walk anywhere, you know, I ain't got to worry about the cops or, you know, looking over my shoulder and it feels good because I've been through that life before. I've been through jail 3 times. You know, I've been shot twice, you know what I'm saying? So I'm not in the streets no more. Mm-hmm. So I turned my whole life around and put it to, you know, visual.
You've been through all that pain in here?
Yeah. No, I ain't been, when I was in Queens, because I moved from Queens. Mm-hmm. I'm born and raised in Queens. Okay. So when I moved back here in the 80s, mm-hmm. It was way worse than what it is now. You know, and it was like I seen bodies drop every day. Every day. So it's like, yo, I'm not going to be a victim. So this is what I had to do. I had to set what I want to do. And I got caught up in the streets. You know, I got locked up 3 times. And it took 3 times. And no, I'm going to tell you what really took it. When my mom's passed, then that made me think about, okay, where I want to go in life. You know what I'm saying? Even though I was, you know, still in the streets, I wasn't as much as in the streets as well. In 97. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, that really, you know, slowed me down. And then my last bid, it was on some humbug, you know, so my last bid, it was a federal bid. So I was like, yo, you know, I can't do this no more. Mm-hmm. You know, I came home, learned the business, learned the music business. You know, I started doing music, like managing artists and all that stuff. And now I never, like me, Sean KD, never went to school for none of this, like filming, writing, and none of that. Mm-hmm. We just picked up the camera and just did some little documentary. And we just learned from our mistakes. And no, I gotta give credit to my man Zaire because he's more into the film. He was way into the film before us, so he gave us pointers like, yo, dude, you should do this, you should do that.
Who's Zaire?
Zaire, he was actually the director for our first movie, Tycoon.
Okay.
So he shot that, and he gave us pointers of how to film, how to shoot, like what angles to shoot, and all that stuff like that. So Zaire, definitely, I give homage to him too as well.
No doubt.
You know.
So I'm gonna spin it around the room and just ask how everyone dealing with, you know, this notoriety, because I know I'm going to catch somebody talking about they, you know, they getting real loopy in 3D, so don't even play with me. I'm telling you, I'm going to follow y'all around for 2 days. And yo, come in the camera, my G. And yo, let them know how you dealing with the notoriety, you know what I'm saying, throughout New York City with, you know, with just, you know, this project Heat Wave right now. Let the viewers know, man.
Dealing with it, staying humble, man. Just love the fans when they come up. It's just crazy. I can't walk nowhere now without nobody noticing me from Project Heat. But no, I love it. It's good. It makes me feel like I made it, even though I didn't yet. You feel me?
But yo, in the business, you have to fake it till you make it. Yo, that's real. Like, you have to really walk like that, though. Not for nothing until you get that bag.
You already know, yeah.
So you ain't taking advantage of none of the Ronies at all? Like, dude, I know the groupies is going here in Vegas. Stop playing with me. So I'm going to follow you around for 2 days. Like, which publication you said followed y'all around for 2 days?
We had Al Jazeera. We had Daily Vice. Had... I forgot the name. The one in Canada. The one in Canada, they came too. I forgot the name of that.
No doubt. I'm gonna definitely look into this. Hey, my bro. Hey, yo, let them. No, it's all good. Hey, let them know how you handling it, because I already know what it's hit for. Talk to me nice, man.
Well, first and foremost, I was a fan first before I got on the series. Okay. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna tell you the story right now. I'm Muslim, so salam alaikum to all everybody. I ran into my Muslim brother Theo, whatever. So he was in my hood. So I said, yo, so I always watch the show. I said, yo, whatever, I need to, you know what I mean? So he said, yo, this is what I'm gonna do for you. He told me where to come. I said, well, I know. He said, but you be in the piece anyway. I said, all right, cool. So I came, one day I just came. So I'm running all over. Come over here, go over there, like, yo, where Project Heat at? Where Pop at? So nobody wanna tell me nothing. Like, I'm from the hood, I already know what it's hitting for. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So I'm like, all right, bro. So I go back on the other side of the piece, cause I got family in here. So then I came back, you know what I mean? Because I called him every day, like, yo, bro, you know what I mean? This after the fact, though. Yeah. So then he told me, he said, yo, you look at Project Heat? I said, yeah. He said, who you? I said, I'm Reem, I'm Theo, boy. He said, all right, come on. Okay, man. Then he said, yo, son, I can't get you in right now, but I got you. Every day I'm calling him like this, yo, Bob, son, you know me. I got to, you know, I'm in the street, son. I can't do this, son. Come on, son. Every day I'm hitting, son. I guess I got on son's nerves so much. He's like, yo, let me get him. So, you know what I mean? So here I go. But, you know what I mean? When I say he a good, humble dude, bro, he a good, humble dude, bro. You know what I mean? When he say he got you, he got you, bro. He not going to leave you behind.
Yo, that's what I've been hearing. And on camera, you said you got me. You know what I'm saying? So we going to hold you to that, Pop. No doubt.
But, you know, I love it. I'm dedicated. No doubt. I'm PH all day. You know what I mean? So... it's whatever. You know what I mean?
I'm going to keep it 100. He's a dedicated fan, supporter, actor. I mean, it was times where we went down to Atlanta to go shoot the Project Heat Atlanta, this man took the bus. Mm-hmm. He didn't have that much money. He's like, yo, I'm coming. Mm-hmm. I'm coming, Pop. I'm coming. He was calling me, yo, what's going on? I'm coming. And that nigga made it. And he came on a bus, that was 18, 16 hours?
Yeah, about 17 hours, man.
I though. You know, but, you know, I'm loyal to it, man. And I love each, every one of them, man. Like, they my brother and sisters. I go all my way for them. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? But, you know, I'm humble. You know what I mean? I stay the same. I don't get out of my lane or nothing. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I'm humble. You know what I mean? I get people, oh, my God. Reem, how you doing? You all right? I'm like, thank you. I love you was a good act. I'll be humble about it. You know, it's kind of crazy.
Hey, yo, I ain't gonna front, man. Hey, yo, it's something about you, man, that just reflects, like you gonna play that role. Like, when them chicks come through, you gonna play a game, man. What's up?
It's the beard, man.
That's what it is.
They like,
man.
The beard, man. I'm like, thank you. They're crazy.
They love them.
It's crazy, but you know, other than that, I'm just here to perfect my craft and bring the magic and excitement that everybody looking for. You know what I mean?
As you do, and as you should.
Facts.
Hey, yo, brother, come on, step into the light. Let them know how you know what I'm saying, taking it to this, you know what I'm saying, notoriety, man. Talk to me nice, bro.
I mean, you don't know, man. It's it gets real spicy out here. I'm telling you, I almost thought I had beef, and I took the situation the wrong way, because it really was people paying homage from seeing you and loving what you've been doing, but it's the way that they be doing it sometimes that be, you know, catch you off guard. And as far as the ladies, I mean, you ain't no more train taking. You can forget about it. You take the train. I mean, if she can be single, she could be pushing a baby, but she could be with a man. But she's watching Project Heat, and that's what lets me know that Project Heat is breaking, like, from single to couple to older to younger. These people are really coming up to me, telling me, yo, I seen you, yo. You know what I'm saying? It got that real global connection. You know what I'm saying? So it's an honor. I'm humble. I think Pop, for, you know, seeing the vision, you know, taking brothers, putting brothers in situations where we can work together and we can paint a picture that's big. So it's an honor, it's a pleasure, and Team Project Heat, man, Hollywood. You know what I'm talking about?
More or less. Hey, yo, bro, talk to me. Hey, yo, let the viewers know how you dealing with it, man.
I'm just chilling. I just chill all the time. But it's good to be known. I went out to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania.
No doubt.
Like, while I was out there, people actually knew who I was. You know what I mean? Like, that means people was actually watching.
You go anywhere, and they're going to know who you are. You got to look at the views, man, because I'm telling you, they're going to know who you are.
At the end of the day, I just stay cool because, you know, it's my uncle put me in. It's my uncle. Papa's my uncle. Mm-hmm. He put me in. And, like, all reality, he's just getting started with me. So, yeah, like, it's a lot more from me I got to see. So,
no doubt.
This is just a door opener.
No doubt. Hey, yo. Not for nothing, man. Do any of you guys have any talent outside of, you know what I'm saying, acting in Project Heat? Like what's really good? Like, because I know y'all cats ain't just wake up in the morning like, oh, I'm going to be an actor. Like, I know it's a couple boss spitters in the building. I know it's a couple, you know what I mean, pool players. Like, what's up, man? I got to take y'all to the billiards or something like that? What's happening?
Hey, ain't you Lady Brother?
Yeah, how you know?
Because that's my homegirl. I seen you in a lot of her pictures.
All right,
so, you know, could you please, you know, let the viewers know who, you know, I'm pretty sure they already know, but, you know, for the viewers that don't know, could you let them know your participation and your character in Project Heat?
What's up? First off, I want to shout out my team, Project Heat, Short Films, yeah. All day. Team Us.
She's grabbing
my bad.
It's all good.
I play Keisha in Project Heat. I'm Pop Girl. I'm more like the ride or die chick for my team. And I'm also Lady, which is Pop twin sister. I'm her BFF. And, you know, we're getting it out there. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right, so quick question. How are you dealing with, you know, like the, because not for nothing, you know, like, not for nothing, you're definitely looking like a Roni, you know what I'm saying? So I already know you was already wavy before the cameras and all of that, but I want to know how you dealing with, like, the new notoriety, and, like, because I know people notice you from the show because it's definitely, you know, one of the top web series in the world. So, like, how are you dealing with, like, people running down on you saying, oh, I know you, and this and that, and third. Like, are you welcoming or are you more, like, standoffish with them?
Oh, no, I fuck with the fans. I love them. Like, I greet them good. It's all good when I see them.
You said you greet them good?
Yeah.
I'm a fan. What happened?
I got you.
No doubt. So listen, do you have any talent outside of, you know, doing the acting with Project Heat? Like what was your thing before you was doing this? Like, do you have any talent? Do you rap, sing, paint, draw? You know, do you do some karate, you know? What happened?
I drink. Nah.
Me too. Hey, yo, good answer.
Nah, I'm cool. I just be doing me out here. I don't know.
No doubt.
Yeah,
so listen, let them know where you can be contacted via social media.
You can find me on Instagram, Keisha Show Up, and on Facebook, Annie Riri Silliman. You can even go to our Project Heat page. It's Project Heat Show Up.
All right, no doubt. Listen, when I follow you on social media, would you be kind enough to follow me back? Don't leave me hanging. I don't like it.
Oh, no, I follow back. I don't act like that.
No doubt. You will one day, trust me. It's going to be some people you're not even really trying to, like, get next to like that. They'll be trying to get next to you crazily. But, yo, thank you so much for your participation. Hey, let them know your participation in Project Heat if they don't already know already.
I'm Detective Crew. I play... the detective on the show. I'm also Hollywood Jay's girlfriend. Well, I'm sure if y'all watch the series, y'all already know. He kind of asked me to join the force, you know, to be the inside eye or whatever, eyes and ears. And it gets tough because he's a dog. But I mean, that's about it. You got to kind of watch the series to really know what exactly.
Tune in. So how are you dealing with the notoriety? Because, you know, you stand out like a sore, stick out and stand up like a sore thumb. You know, you got yellow, you got blonde hair, you got green fur, your light skin. I can see you from a mile away. How are you dealing with people running down like, oh, there she go? Are you running from them or are you waiting for them to come up and get inside an autograph?
No, I mean, I greet everybody, you know. We love our fans. Like, all the Project Heat, we all love our fans. Like, without them, we'd be nothing, so.
Everybody love the fans? But it's different for females because, you know, guys be trying to run down. They have ulterior motives. Oh, well, yeah?
We all family. They are.
No doubt.
They sure do.
So basically, you're saying that you're more welcoming than being standoffish.
Exactly.
Okay, so, you know, another question for you. Do you have any talent outside of the acting with Project Heat? What are you into?
I wish I did. I wish I could sing. I wish I could do... No, I just act. I graduated. I went to theater school, so. Okay. I mean, that's my passion.
Okay,
that's what I do.
Okay, so it's suitable for what you're doing right now.
Exactly.
Okay, let the viewers know where you can be contacted via social media if they're not already following you.
My Instagram is AshleyShowUp. My Facebook is Ashley Creary. I got a snap, but I don't really know the name. So.
No, you got a snap, but you don't really want to share it. You know what I'm saying? Because the snap is when you really get 3D. You think, I don't know. You know what I'm saying? Like, Facebook is family oriented. Instagram is when you want to be a little ratchet. Snap is when you let it, when you bust it wide open. You think, I don't know. I know what the social media is about.
Don't even worry about it. Got what you need.
Wow. So talk to me. What's the numbers looking like?
Hey, yo, let them know where you could be contacted via social media if they don't already know, Pop.
You can find me on Instagram, Pop Show Up, and you can find me on Facebook, Tiffon Dunn, TiffonDunn. And that's basically it. And you definitely subscribe to Show Up Films.
Subscribe.
And
like, comment, and subscribe.
Yeah, for sure. And join our fan page, Project Heat, on Facebook.
No doubt.
And on Instagram.
No doubt. I'm definitely going to follow you on all the social media names that you have. And I want you to follow me back. Don't leave me in the friend zone, man. I'm active social media.
100. I'm going to keep it 100. I'll be getting a lot of requests from a lot of people. If I don't know you, I'm not going to add you.
No doubt.
You know, but now that, you know, you put me on, you're going to be, yeah. I got you, sir.
No doubt. Thank you so much. It means everything to me. Hey, yo, let them know where you can be contacted via social media, man. Come on, get a camera. Let them know where you can be contacted via social media. If they haven't tuned in, you know what I'm saying, to Project Heat, which they will after we finish this script, but let them know.
You can catch me on Facebook, Shamal Steele, Shamalstelle. And just look out for me with the music, Headshot the Boss. You already know, K-Man Side, Bankstop Boys, day one.
Headshot the Boss? Do you have any music on any social media, SoundCloud, YouTube? What's happening? Like, say that.
I'm working on my music right now, so... I say you can look forward for my first mixtape like around my birthday, 2017, January 2nd.
Okay. What? Money now. I'm out here now. Yeah.
Hey, let them know where you can be contacted via social media.
You can check me out on Facebook, Reem Jones on Facebook. You know what I mean? You can catch me on Instagram. You know what I mean? Greybeard Reem, that's me, the handsomeness. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But you know. And also, I got a little record label, you know, Phenine is Productions, all females. So, you know, look out for that.
Hey, yo, I ain't gonna front, man. Hey, yo, I like to come check that out. I like to come check that one out, all females. Hey, yo, I like to come check that out. So you got rappers and singers?
Yeah.
Okay, yeah. Cool. Any dancers?
Nah.
Are you looking for something? I can break you, sir, bro. What you
we
want?
We gonna talk.
Hey, yo, let them know where you can be contacted via social media.
Well, you already know it's your boy Hollywood Trigg. You can catch me at Lyrical Lethal on everything, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, LinkedIn, wherever you want to go, you can catch me at Lyrical Lethal. Ball game.
Hey, yo, you got bars too?
We got some things in storage and we about to unleash them. So, you know, when the time is right, that's gonna be our next interview.
So it's quiet for that right now?
It's quiet.
I'm coming back for another interview though.
I said that we gonna leave those things to focus on in the next interview. This interview, we gonna focus on this heat that's coming out of the projects. Ball game.
Say less. Hey, yo, let them know where you could be contacted via social media.
You can find me on Facebook and SoundCloud at Majestic Mick Spiffy. That's MCSPIFFY. You know, Instagram, that's Majestic BDF_URM.
What is UIM?
It's Underrated Mind. Speaking of that, follow that. This is my clothing line. I told you I'm a jack of all trades. I got a clothing line.
Oh, word? Hey, yo, wait, do you got any clothes on you right now? Like anything in the bag somewhere close
oh,
by?
Oh, nah, see, I didn't know it was going to go down
word,
like this.
Son, I love merch, man. So, love
yeah, merch. So, yeah, we gonna get up. Yeah, we gonna get up about that, but yeah.
Not for nothing, man. Hey, yo, you know, you can't count me out, man. I'm going to be in front of these cameras a lot, man, in front of a lot of people, you know, gaining this notoriety, too. I promote that brand, boy, for real.
Definitely, but you can find me on Reverb Nation, too. But make sure y'all follow my SoundCloud, Majestic McSpiffy and Reverb. Listen to the music. I got some heat for y'all. Right now, I'm just throwing a lot of stuff out just to show y'all I ain't playing with these niggas. So, be ready for the God.
Shane B, let them know where you could be contacted via social media, baby.
You can catch me on IG all day, The Real Shane B. That's D-A, Real Shane B.
That's a big fact. Hey, yo.
She's awesome.
Yo, oh, she's very awesome. Hey, yo, listen, I'm going to slap all y'all daps. Hey, yo, y'all officially in the mix, man. I ain't even going to front. Thank y'all so much for y'all participation, man. Y'all were definitely far too kind, son. Hey, yo, not for nothing. We all going to patch all the way in, so I ain't even going to hold y'all. I'm definitely rocking with the spirit. Anyway, Twix, man, in the mix with Twix. New York City time. If you don't watch my show, you show is ugly, and we out of here like shampoo. Shout out to the world, man. Hey, yo, shout out to D. Wills, man, my executive producer. Shout out to Shane Sharp. Shout out to Loyal Squad A. Shout out to Young Liddy, look out for all the music, man. Everything that they say, where they could be contacted, it will appear on the screen, man. So, you know, once again, if you don't watch my show, you show is ugly, and we out of here like shampoo. 100. Hennemix,